Thank you. Back here in the valley, the city of Phoenix is taking action to help prevent fires. Starting today, the Parks and Rec Department is banning open fires in the city's desert and mountain preserves, and that includes smoking and charcoal fires.
Back to the teacher walkout. So many of us being impacted by this walkout, including the Arizona Department of Child Safety. According to the agency, since the walkout started last Thursday, DCS has seen a drop in the number of calls to their hotline, since teachers so often the ones to report abuse and neglect. For the first 3 days of the walkout, DCS received an average of 431 hotline calls each day. Compare that to an average of 591 calls during the same days last year.
Well, Katie, the walkout leaves many parents trying to figure out how exactly they're going to feed their children while they're home from school. 580,000 Arizona students qualify for free or reduced lunches and breakfast. ABC 15's Justin Pizarro is at St. Mary's Food Bank, and Justin, they're getting creative, trying to feed the need that's out there with these kids.
Yes, Steph, this is a little bit different from what they're used to doing. We're actually at one of six distribution sites that they have set up across the valley. You can see these folks right here. They've been out here all afternoon passing out these food bags. This is basically a couple of days worth of food in those bags. It's pretty much been a steady stream of families coming by here. In some cases, you actually see the students walking up to pick up these bags. We were talking about those free and reduced lunches. About 580,000 students qualify for them. That's why this